Every day, NCBA, through beef checkoff-funded programs, works to maintain and grow consumer demand for beef. Here to talk more about these efforts is Alisa Harrison. She's Senior Vice President of Global Marketing and Research for NCBA. So tell us, how do you even attempt to stay abreast of the changing consumer preferences and demands?
Yeah. We are out there looking every day about what consumers are thinking, what they're demanding, through a pretty intensive consumer research program. We've got a monthly tracker, that's kind of research terms, where we are talking to thousands of consumers every month about all kinds of issues related to beef production and beef. We do focus groups, we talk to consumers, and then also through our state beef councils, we're also talking to those consumers locally about how they're feeling about beef, what they think about beef, and what they like most about beef.
And so tell us, how do you share that information or those insights with consumers?
Yeah. Well, we take that information and we develop programs that we think will resonate with consumers. So we have found through our research that consumers still have some questions about how their food is produced. Mm. Not just beef, but all food.
Right.
And so we delve down to find out what their questions are, and then we develop programs to answer those questions, and then we deliver those in a way that will be meaningful to them, that we present it to them in a way that they want to receive it on the platforms they want to receive it, and have a two-way dialogue with consumers today, because that really is the name of the game. You can't just be pushing information out. You have to be asking their questions and then responding back.
It really is engaging with them, not just communicating to them.
Exactly.
And speaking of that, you can't pick up any magazine without talking about the important role of millennials. I'm curious, what have you specifically done to educate, engage with millennials? Yeah. Excuse me.
Well, our target audience is that older millennial parent, because that's really, you know, millennials are the biggest sector of our demographic today.
Mm-hmm.
And they're, as they start to get older and they start to have kids, what they're feeding their families is becoming more important to them. Mm-hmm. But they're also very social. They're on digital media. They are not even watching television anymore. They are getting it all through connected TV, connected platforms. So we are providing the information where they are, whether it's YouTube, Hulu, Pinterest, Facebook, all of the digital platforms. But we're also using some technology that they're using in gaming and some of the other things that they're doing, like artificial intelligence.
Wow.
So last year we launched Chuck Knows Beef, which
is
using artificial intelligence as a digital assistant. So they can they can ask Chuck a question, they can type Chuck a question, they can text him, because the biggest questions that consumers have today is, how do you produce beef? How do you actually make it? Because they're not as familiar with the cuts, they're not as familiar with cooking techniques.
Mm-hmm.
So any way that we can get that information to them in the way they want it is starting to pay off for us when it comes to beef demand.
Yeah, that's amazing. You know, it's funny you talk about television, because I remember watching the original Beef It's What's for Dinner commercial.
Yes.
And speaking of which, you just relaunched the Beef It's What's for Dinner campaign a couple of years ago. Can you update us on how that's going?
Sure. We relaunched it and made it more relevant to today's consumers, that older millennial parent. Mm-hmm. Try to make it more relevant to them, focusing on the attributes that distinguish beef from other protein sources like chicken and pork and some of the newer products that we're seeing in the marketplace today. And there are three things that distinguish beef. One, the taste of beef, number one. It really is. No one can beat that. Two, the nutritional value that you get from beef. It's more, it's a protein-packed punch that we like to say.
Mm-hmm.
But more importantly, people love cattle producers. And so the people who are producing the product really resonates with those consumers today. So we take all three of those as part of what we call pillars to the Beef It's What's for Dinner brand. And we're just seeing nothing but success. We do know that when people are aware and familiar with the Beef It's What's for Dinner brand,
mm-hmm.
they tend to say that beef is their number one protein.
Wow.
And so we have seen a continual increase in the awareness of Beef It's What's for Dinner. And therefore, we've seen a continual increase of those consumers who choose beef as their number one protein. That's not the only protein,
mm-hmm.
but it's still their favorite. And that's what we're able to track through our ongoing consumer research that we do every month.
That's great news.
Yeah.
And you mentioned producers, and I guess my question to you, for those people watching the show, what guidance would you have about how producers should engage in telling the beef story? Yeah.
Well, first of all, producers should engage because, as I said, producers are the best spokespeople that we have. Consumers are very fond of farmers and ranchers. They trust farmers and ranchers. They have a lot of questions for farmers and ranchers, and they see them as credible sources. Mm. At NCBA, we're the largest contractor to the Beef Checkoff. We have a program called Masters of Beef Advocacy that's online, or you can have some in-person opportunities at the state level to learn how to talk to consumers about all of these issues. But more importantly, we encourage producers to engage with that consumer like we talked about. Get on Facebook, get on Pinterest, get on Twitter, and have that conversation, because consumers like to have that one-on-one, not only with producers, but anyone, things that they're buying. So join Masters of Beef Advocacy, and then if you're, get online if you're not online, and if you are online, get out there and start helping us educate consumers about how beef is responsibly raised today, about how beef is superior in taste, and how beef really meets that nutritional profile for a healthy diet.
That's great advice. Yeah. Thank you so much for coming to the show.
Well, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Now, don't forget, you can check out the Beef It's What's for Dinner website for a great interactive experience. You'll find things like recipes, information on beef cuts, and nutritional information at this one-stop shop for all things beef.